emotionally, where do we catch up with you in this upcoming season?
I think that at the end of last year had a little bit of closure. Even though it came out of the blue, my relationship with Claire sort of ended. She put an end to it, and I think that while it was painful, I understood where she was coming from in terms of our relationship not being one that was going to really have a chance to pan out too much. And I think that I say to Joe, I'm going to have a life that doesn't involve you. You know, you're in jail now, and I really am really ready to move past you. I'm making good on that. I'm also still not drinking, and I'm back with the FBI, and having a more, you know, having some level of domesticity with a new partner, and hopefully in a happier place. You know, I mean, obviously, that's not going to last for 2 years.
Is it really possible for Ryan to have a life without Joe? I mean,
we'll see.
He's kind of part of him.
We'll see.
So yeah. the spark that you had with James Purefoy, I mean, just. You don't see that in a lot of scenes like you played together. Where do you see that coming in season 3 with him out of the picture? Is there another big bad that we're going to...
There is another big bad for sure, at least one. And the size of, you know, it's kind of teased on the poster that they gave out at Comic-Con, when they said Joe Carroll was just the beginning. Yeah, Joe Carroll was just the beginning. So the size and scope of this big bad or the evil that sort of come from this is just a tip of the iceberg, which is you know, kind of exciting. In terms of the, you know, playing those scenes, I think there's a lot of fantastic actors on the show, and certainly my scenes with Joe were always fun because, you know, he's a fantastic actor, and also I think that Kevin Williamson really loved writing to that kind of tennis match that we would play. But he's going to be around for he's going to be around, so hopefully we'll get in the room together.
You've been through some dark places,
yeah,
in the show. Are you going to be able to come back to the bright side instead of the dark side? And is Ryan going to be able to help you with that?
I think that Mike's journey is not complete yet, and I'm sure that he'll descend down a little further maybe before it gets better. And I think that's going to be an interesting thing. And I'm talking about this relationship with Max being sort of that light that could potentially pull him out of it. But there's something underneath Mike, and I think we saw it even in the first season, even before. I think that, you know, there's something underneath there. There's an anger and sort of now certainly revenge that's bubbling underneath the surface with him that I really think will still be around. And as far as Ryan being able to help Mike, I think Ryan was trying to help Mike the entire season, but it's one of those things that you can't tell somebody. I think I understand that Ryan has gone through these things and is experiencing things, is probably trying to help him, but how do you, it's just one of those things you have to experience. Like, my dad has been killed, and you can't tell me not to do that, not to feel that. And I think that I'm sure the people were trying to help, and his friends in the case prior were trying to tell Ryan not to experience that, to pull out of that. How do you do that? You know, you have to live what you feel, and this is such extreme trauma that I think these guys are going to react the way they're going to react. And it's more maybe about the aftermath, about helping, being there after the fact. Whatever these guys do, you know, that might be how Ryan can help them.
So it was brought up earlier, you know, we were discussing what was shown at the panel where there was an alternate ending. Like, do you feel that it kind of went with the right ending that was aired, and the reason behind that?
I do. Because I think that... I think that, you know, why not just keep the Joe Carroll character alive a little bit longer? see him in a different in a different place. I mean, you keep in mind that we met Joe in jail.
Right.
And maybe there's something about that.
It's almost full circle.
Yeah.
I mean, I agree too. I think that the reason was that it was probably a very shocking, interesting way to end the season. You know what I mean?
Right.
But I think that the way it worked out was nice. And I also say that, you know, Joe Carroll will always be with these characters, one way or another. You know, the mark that he's left on everybody will not easily go away. So I think Joe will be with all of us, probably until we're all gone.
Are you enjoying the overall arc of the character?
I am,
from
yeah.
season one, episode one, to where you are now?
I am. You know, I have my moments when I go, you know, I wish they would go in one direction or another direction or whatever. But yeah, I do. I mean, it's also just that thing. This is my first TV series, so the idea that it is an ongoing process is really new and cool. You know, I mean, I just finished a movie. You know, I look at that movie. I say, okay, I got these five scenes. Now I got to try to tell as much of a story with these five scenes as I possibly can. And even within that, who knows how many of these are going to end up in the movie? Maybe one, maybe none, maybe five. Who knows? Whereas with the series, you know, well, I've never seen a softer side of Ryan. Well, we still have, you know, 7, 8 more episodes than that could possibly be then. Well, you know, I've never seen him deal with his parents. Well, boom, there. You know what I mean? It's like all this stuff is available and changing. It's one of the cool things about it.
Is Ryan still pursuing police work?
Yes, he's with the FBI.
Okay.
So Ryan has had such a hard, hard history. How does he keep coming back for more?
Well, he's a tough motherfucker.
Well, and one of the things that I really think about as I'm watching this show is really who is the follower and who is the leader. And I think that piece of each character seems to have the potential to go either way.
Right.
So what do you think about your characters?
Yeah, I mean, look, I certainly could, you could argue that through the first two seasons I've been following Joe Carroll, that's what I did.
Vice versa. I mean, again, everybody from the beginning, everybody was like, oh, Mike's a bad guy, and he's following Ryan, and he's going to turn, and all these things. But that's the interesting thing. Those seeds were planted very early that, you know, we don't know who to trust. And all these characters do have this duality. It's like, again, you know, I looked up to Ryan at a certain point, and then season two, I stopped listening to Ryan. You know, I went on every word. You know, well, what's Ryan telling me to do? How to do, you know. So I think there is that back and forth constantly with all these characters, which is, you know, interesting, different.